We were talking about the syndromes in ENT. Today's class, we will discuss Eagle syndrome or the styloid-carotid artery syndrome. So, the headings will be, what is it, what are the causes, clinical presentation, diagnosis, treatment and prognosis. So, in the skull base, here comes mastoid, mandible, then external carotid artery, internal carotid artery, this one, IJV, and also your cranial nerve 10 or the vagus nerve also comes in among this. And external auditory canal, bony part, and this is a styloid process. So you know this is something related to the styloid process, and this Eagle syndrome is due to the elongated styloid process or calcification of the stylohyoid ligament. Hyoid bone will come somewhere here. So either an elongated styloid process or calcification of the stylohyoid ligament, and it is characterized by the pain, especially on the throat and on the neck, and which is referred into the ipsilateral area. So that is Eagle syndrome. And we know about the Eagle syndrome from 17th century, but it was first described by this Watvieum's Eagle, an American otolaryngologist who was working with the Duke's University, and he described this in 1937. So, before talking on elongated styloid process, what is the normal length of styloid process? So, in normal length, in Caucasians, it is around 20 to 30 millimeters. And in adult Asians, it is 18. We can take it as 15 to 18 millimeters. Okay, so the length more than 30 millimeters or more than 3 centimeters is taken as an elongated styloid process. Okay, so this Eagle syndrome is seen more in females than to above 60 years of age. And it is usually unilateral, but can happen bilaterally also. So females above 60 years, unilateral, that's a common presentation. We all have a styloid process. But why this is elongated in some patients, and also among the elongated styloid process, only a few patients are having the pain, and that only a few patients are having this Eagle syndrome. So why it happens, or otherwise what are the causes? So, among the causes, one is congenital, persistence of the or formation of an embryonic cartilaginous outgrowth. Then, I already talked about the stylohyoid ligament. So, calcification of the stylohyoid ligament will lead to this Eagle syndrome. And also, at the insertion of the stylohyoid ligament, there is formation of bone tissue. Either calcification of the stylohyoid ligament, or at the point of insertion of the stylohyoid ligament, there can be formation of a bone tissue. And this clinical picture is seen in patients after tonsillectomy. Okay. The same clinical picture of Eagle syndrome might be seen in patients after tonsillectomy also. So these are the causes. Mainly, this is something related to the styloid process or to the stylohyoid ligament. So what are the clinical features? We can divide the clinical features into a classic form and a vascular form. So if this styloid process is elongated, or if there is calcification of the stylohyoid ligament, this will be elongated in between this internal carotid and external carotid artery, and it can be elongated. Okay. So, mainly this will cause compression of the cranial nerve, especially on the ninth nerve as it passes over the superior constrictor muscle. Or this can cause compression of the carotid artery, or it can cause compression of the jugular vein. Okay. So, the classic form, there is mainly compression of the cranial nerve, mainly compression of the 9th nerve, but there can be compression of 10th nerve or 5th and 7th also. There will be facial pain, especially on turning the head towards that side, or there will be foreboding sensation of the throat, dysphagia, pain on extending the tongue, or tinnitus or otalgia. So these are the clinical features of the classic form. And vascular form, again we can divide into compression due to compression on the carotid and also compression on the jugular vein. This arterial impingement, if it is compressing on the carotid artery, there can be either a mechanical compression or it can cause compress on the sympathetic plexus, which are seen around the carotids. So mechanical compression can cause visual symptoms, pre-syncope and syncope. All these you can remember by remembering this picture. Okay, visual symptoms can happen, or there can be a pre-syncope or syncope. Very rarely there can be a carotid dissection, and stroke can also happen. Okay, so stroke can happen, but it is very rare. So that is due to mechanical compression. But if there is sympathetic plexus irritation, it can lead to eye pain or the parietal pain. Okay, so eye pain or a pain over the parietal area. Parietal, okay. I can see if it is impinging on the internal jugular vein, that condition is called a styloidogenic jugular vein compression syndrome. Jugular vein compression due to styloid process. So styloidogenic jugular vein compression syndrome, and this will result, the symptom will be due to venous outflow obstruction, and it can lead to a pseudo tumor cerebral. Okay. So these are the clinical features, either classical form because of the compression on the cranial nerve, especially on cranial nerve 9, glossopharyngeal nerve, as it crosses over the superior constrictor muscle, leading to pain, especially on movement of the neck, and also dysphagia, tinnitus, earache, etc. Or the vascular form, it can be either due to arterial impingement, it can be either mechanical or due to sympathetic nerve irritation, sympathetic plexus irritation, or it can be due to a venous impingement, which lead to jugular vein compression syndrome, venous outflow obstruction, and pseudo tumor cerebral. So these are the clinical features, and there are some differential diagnosis. So in the differential diagnosis, mainly glossopharyngeal and trigeminal neuralgia, temporal arthritis or a cervical arthritis, then migraine, cluster headache, myofascial pain dysfunction syndrome, dental pain, especially a partly erupted or an unerupted third molar, or ill-fitting dentures, and also tumors. So all this has to be differentiated from an Eagle syndrome, and the diagnosis is mainly by the clinical features and also by the physical examination. An intraoral palpation, one can palpate an elongated styloid process, and this elongated styloid process on palpation will cause pain in case of an Eagle syndrome, because in 4% of the normal population have an elongated styloid process, and then all of them do not have this pain. So if we are palpating the styloid process and it is inducing pain, and then there is chance of an Eagle syndrome. So physical exam, clinical features, clinical history, and then physical examination. We can also go for radiological investigations like an orthopantomogram and also CT scan. CT scan of the neck with 3D reconstruction is taken to be the gold standard in the diagnosis of this elongated styloid process and also the styloid ligament complex. Okay, so physical diagnosis is by the typical history. Physical examination, that is palpation of elongated styloid process which induces pain, and also an orthopantomogram, along with the, if needed, we can go for a 3D reconstruction of the CT neck. Okay, so in the treatment, what is the treatment of Eagle syndrome? I already told you that 4% of the normal of the population is having elongated styloid process. Of the 4%, only 4 to 10% is having clinical features or symptoms which are difficult to manage. So in this small percentage, reassurance along with the analgesics will be enough. Or we can go for a transpharyngeal injection of steroid or a local anesthetic agent. Okay. And if it is not getting relieved by these measures, then a surgical styloidectomy is required and with the cure rate of 80%. And the treatment of choice of a symptomatic Eagle syndrome is surgical styloidectomy, be it a transoral, which is commonly used approach, or it can be, there is also a lateral approach. Okay.